In this video, we'll walk you through setting up Stream Deck Mobile and how to get started using it. Stream Deck Mobile offers 6 free keys that you can use to control your PC or Mac's applications, audio, streaming software, and more. But with a Pro upgrade, it can be expanded from 1 key to 8x8 for 64 keys, as well as customizable faceplates. More on that later. To begin, download and install the Stream Deck desktop software to your PC or Mac from elgato.com/downloads. Then, pair your mobile device to your computer by going to the device dropdown in the Stream Deck program, choose Add Mobile Device, and then following the steps shown on your device. If you have any issues pairing, we'll have a section at the end of the video with more information. Once paired, your iPhone or iPad is talking with your computer wirelessly over Wi-Fi. No cables needed. But you may want to keep your device connected to power to continue using it for long periods of time. Stream Deck is all about actions, and that's no exception with Stream Deck Mobile. Actions are functions that you assign to a key. An action could be a hotkey to press a special keyboard combination for you, a mute action for muting your mic or speakers anytime you tap on it, or maybe even changes which camera you're streaming with. There's nearly limitless options, but we'll keep it simple here. On the right side of the Stream Deck software, you'll find the actions list. Here you can see various categories of actions, from controlling your system to controlling Microsoft Teams or a system's volume. We have Photoshop open, and it can have some annoying shortcuts like Ctrl-Alt-Shift-W to export a file, or Ctrl-Alt-I to resize something. That's not always fast to do. We'll use a hotkey action to make this easier. Inside of the system category, drag hotkey onto an open key. Down below, this area is called the Property Inspector. This is where all the options for an action are found. For the hotkey, this is where we put the keyboard presses we want. We can press Ctrl, Shift, and Alt on our keyboard, and then finally press W, and the Stream Deck will add it to the box. You can also use the drop-down menu next to the hotkey box to browse various keys to use. If you hold a modifier key like Ctrl or Alt, this list will update to show what you're selecting. Every action on a key has an icon that can be configured, either from the icon library or using an image on your computer. You can create custom icons yourself or by using our key creator. We'll have that linked down below. You can also type in a custom title for your action using the title box. You can change font size, typeface, color, and more. Now, instead of having to contort our hands to use this key combo, we just press one key. Next up, we have some websites that we find ourselves visiting a lot. What if our Stream Deck could take us there? It can using the website action. This is found in the same system category. Drag it onto a key and enter the URL you want to visit. Now when you tap on this key, that website will open using your default browser. You can also open files, folders, or programs using the open action. Like before, drag it onto a key. Navigate to a folder to open, a file to open, like a video or music file, or if you select an executable of a program, it will run that program when you tap on it. A quick way to set up an open action is to simply drag a program's shortcut or other file onto a key. Stream Deck will automatically make an open action for it. Use the close action on the same program executable, and Stream Deck can shut down that program just as easily. As our final example, text paste. This action is super handy if you find yourself typing the same thing a lot for work or when replying to messages, especially useful for holding links to websites. Drag it onto a key from the system category. In the Property Inspector area, type in what you want your Stream Deck to post for you. To use it, all you need to do is click inside of the box to type, tap on the key, and Stream Deck took care of the rest. This action is great for those who maybe do customer service type work from home and find themselves sending repeat information over and over. And don't forget to add a title to your actions. Organize your actions using folders. We have a whole video going over organization that we'll link down below, but here's the basics. Inside of the Stream Deck software, right-click on a key and use Create Folder. Or, if an action is already there, it will say Move to Folder. Drag any related actions into that folder. Now you can store more on the same amount of keys. And you can put folders inside of folders inside of folders for a huge amount of actions. Expand your actions and integrations by checking out Elgato Marketplace, where you can download more plugins to unlock even more for your Stream Deck Mobile. It also has custom profiles, icon packs, and more. Stream Deck Mobile with the Pro upgrade offers customizable virtual faceplates. Head into Settings, then Faceplate, and choose from a selection of Elgato-designed options, or create your own using your own images. While Stream Deck Mobile offers 6 customizable keys for free, with Pro you can go all the way up to 8x8, or 64 keys. That's double of Stream Deck XL. You can make this change on your mobile device by heading into Settings, then Keypad Layout. Then choose between presets based on our physical devices, or go custom, and choose anything from 1 key to 64. The layout on the Stream Deck software will update automatically. Stream Deck Mobile over Wi-Fi is designed to be just as responsive as any other Stream Deck. However, if you happen to experience any hiccups, here's some tips to improve your experience. If you are using Stream Deck Mobile on a 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi network, try switching over to a 5 GHz network if it's available. Most Wi-Fi routers and access points provide 2.4 and 5 GHz networks. 5 GHz is a higher throughput, less congested spectrum, and better for your high-priority computers and devices. While your mobile device connects to the network over Wi-Fi, your PC or Mac doesn't need to be on Wi-Fi. In fact, we suggest keeping those wired using Ethernet if possible, to reduce congestion. If you use animated icons, be aware these can use significantly more network bandwidth than static icons. On most networks, a handful of animated icons will work fine, but maybe not an entire iPad full of GIFs. Or GIFs. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to learn more about the Stream Deck ecosystem, check out our plugin spotlights, where we showcase some of our most popular plugins. If you have any questions, leave a comment down below. And don't forget to like this video and subscribe to us on Elgato Workshop to learn how to get the most out of your Stream Deck and other Elgato products.